By the end of this video, you'll know exactly how to measure the health of your team and put a process in place that will guarantee a gradual and consistent improvement in your team's health. There's a general consensus that healthy teams build better products. I've never met a single person in my life who disagrees with this statement. That's why the focus of a Scrum Master and Agile Coach should be to find ways, always be finding ways to improve the team's health. This statement can be translated to just about any teams in any industry by replacing the word products by whatever the team is responsible for delivering. As an example, for McDonald's, healthy teams make better burgers. Now, it's important to measure team health because we can't improve what we don't measure. And without some sort of systemic approach with clear visualization, it's pretty much a guessing game. The problem with many traditional performance metrics is that they are lagging indicators by the time we see something wrong in the data, the damage has already been done. However, team health metrics, quite different. They are leading indicators. It's like going to the doctors for regular checkups. If you go regularly, you'll find out what will be coming next, what issues you might have in the future. Before talking about some techniques on how to evaluate the health of your team, let's talk about some drawbacks of doing team health checks. Basically, some anti-patterns on team health checks. First, a health check is not a competition or comparison between teams, no matter the results. The only question the organization, leaders in the organization, should be asking is, how can we help? That's it, not why did this team do better than the other team. Second, a health check is not an incentivized model. I often see organizations, leaders, setting team health as KPIs. The team should increase their team health by X percent by the end of the financial year. This is insane. Team health, the only purpose of team health should be supporting and helping the team focus on team improvements. There's many ways to measure team health. I can't possibly talk about all of these techniques in this video. So let's try to focus on a single approach, technique that I've been using for years with great success, the Spotify approach. A few years ago, some agile coaches in the company Spotify developed something called the Squad Health Check model. Basically, everyone doing this exercise would get some traffic light cards, red, green, yellow. Each person in the team would vote based on how they feel the team is doing in multiple areas. And also, what's the trend of the team? Is the trend improving, worsening, or is it stable? On the screen right now, you're seeing an example of what the results would look like. Let's quickly go through all these sections and I explain to you what they mean. Green. Green means awesome. Things are going extremely well. Doesn't have to be perfect, but at least things are good. What it does mean is that the team is happy with this area and sees no need for improvement right now. Yellow. There are some problems that need to be addressed, but it's not yet a dumpster fire. Red, the situation is really poor and we need to do something to address it right away. If you look at the right of the screen, there are some arrows. These are the trends. Up arrow, things are getting better over time. Down arrow, things are getting worse over time. No arrow, things are basically stable over time. Now, let's go through some questions that you can use for each area of this exercise. Let's start with support. Support basically means support, help from everyone involved in building of this product, service, stakeholders, sponsors, any other teams. Are we getting their support when we need it? Green means that we are getting their support when we need it. They are very helpful. Red means that we are currently not getting their support. Something needs to change because we are constantly being blocked by them. Next is teamwork. Do we work well together as a team? Green simply means that we work well together as a team. We have an awesome team. Red means that something needs to be improved here. We might be a bunch of individuals that were put together in a team and no one really cares about each other in the team. We might be called a team, but we don't work as a team. We work as individuals. Something needs to be improved. Next is pawns or players. Do we control our destiny? Green means that we control our destiny. We decide what to build and how to build it. Red means that things are not good. We are maybe some pieces in a game of chess. No control whatsoever on what to build. No choice on what to build and how to build it. Someone else is designing for us. Next is mission. Do we understand why we are here and what we are trying to do? Green means exactly that. We know exactly what our team is trying to accomplish for the team, for the organization, and for the customer. And it's within our skills and team capacity, the members of the team. We can do it, and we know exactly what to do. Green means the opposite, complete opposite. We have no idea whatsoever why we are here. We have no vision, no goals. It's somewhere on a piece of paper, in a drawer. Nothing is shared with the team members. They are not motivated because they have no purpose. They are just working, coding on useless stuff with no goals, with no vision whatsoever. And all the things that we are trying to do, constant pressure, constant deadlines, and there's no end in sight. Next is the health of the code base. Do we have technical debt? Green simply means that we are very proud of a code that we wrote. It's clean, easy to read, and has great test coverage. Next is suitable process. How's our way of working? Green simply means that our way of working suits us perfectly. It's great to work in this environment. And red means that our way of working is really bad and needs to be improved. Next is delivering value, one of the most important areas. Do we really move the needle? Green simply means that we are delivering value. Our customers love what we are producing, the product or maybe the service. Our stakeholders also love us, love the work that we are doing. We are really delivering value. And red simply means that things need to be improved. We are delivering value. Our customers, they don't really care about the product or service we are producing. They don't care about it. We don't even know why we are doing it. Next is learning. Are we learning new stuff? Green simply means that we are always learning new things and using what we've learned. Red simply means that we never learn anything. Next is speed. Do we get stuck often by dependencies? Green simply means that the work is really fast. No waiting time, no getting stuck, no delays. Work is really smooth with dependencies. And red means that it's hell working in this environment constantly, getting stuck, and we can't reach our sprint's commitment. Maybe 25% of a sprint commitment we reach compared to the green, where we reach at least 80% of a sprint's commitment. The next area is easy to release. Green simply means that it's really painless to release, really simple, and it's mostly automated. And red means that it's hell to release. Very painful, takes forever to release, and it's very manual. And the next area is fun. Are we having fun? Green means that we are having fun with the work that we are doing, with our colleagues, with our team, and in the environment. Red means that it's super boring to work in at this place. Now, the most important part, the action part, often ignored by many people who run this exercise. They simply run the exercise and they share the result. That's it, no improvement whatsoever. Action is extremely important. And we can't focus on everything. Ask the team, okay, what should we focus on? In priority, maybe two or three things, maybe one thing, really depends on the team. And you get their commitment. You do some brainstorming sessions, ask them, how can we improve all these areas? And you get all the list of actions. You get some owners, you get some commitments. Maybe you can add these actions in the next sprint planning so that they can work on the actions in the next sprint. And you ensure that you follow up on these actions. As you're a facilitator of this exercise, you follow up on these actions and you ensure that all the actions are done and they are improving the next team health check.